Welcome to the Social Regressive. A few days ago, Federal announced a new cartridge, the 224 Valkyrie. There isn't much data out there about it, but we are going to speculate wildly based on some of the info that they have provided, and I think we're going to get a pretty decent indication of what this cartridge is going to be designed for, and especially how it fits in the market compared to things like the granddaddy, the 223 Remington, and the 22 Nosler, which is still pretty new. It's going to be a kind of a tricky business figuring out which one is going to be used for what applications, but I think just based on what we've seen so far, I think that we can kind of figure out where to apply what cartridge to what purpose. And one of the things that you have to keep in mind as a baseline is that all of these cartridges are designed around this, the AR-15, not the AR-10. Everything is going to be designed to fit within the magazine limitations that you get with an AR-15, which usually tops out at about 2.25 inches, 2.250, or 2.260 on kind of the extreme edge. And we've had all kinds of cartridges out there designed to fit within this and to kind of increase that performance over the old 223. So we're just going to delve into this and we're going to see, do these differences really make a difference? And when do you maybe want to pick one cartridge over the other? And while I've got you right here, I just wanted to point out that this is the Bushnell Engage that I've got sitting up on this AR-15. This is a 2.5 to 10 power. I did a review on this recently, so make sure you go check out that review. It's a really neat scope for actually some of the things that we're going to be talking about. As you start to increase the capabilities of an AR-15, you really want a scope that's going to be able to handle the new situations that confront you. Let's take a close look at 223 Remington. This is the cartridge that defines the limitations of the AR-15 platform. So you get a pretty slim case. It has a 378/1000 rim on there, and the head is pretty much the same diameter, has a decent taper going up to a rather short neck. This is 200/1000 on the length right here. And then total length on the case itself is 1.670 inches, so not all that long. And then total max length is going to be defined by the magazines, and that needs to be about 2.25 inches. And then on the bleeding edge, you can get about 2.260 inside an AR-15 magazine. And that's going to limit the bullets that you can have in this, because you do have a defined case size, and then you have a defined magazine length, and it's all based around this, the 55 grain full metal jacket bullet. And you can start to get into some other fun types of bullets within that weight and that length. So here's a hollow point from Mid-South. These things perform really well on critters. And then you can get into some heavier bullets like these 75 grain Hornady match bullets right here. These do not really expand. It does have a hollow point, but it doesn't act like one. But you can still get some increased distances with this thing. You can increase the energy that you provide on a target. And these are going to work better than either of these in a hunting style of situation. This is just going to provide more energy, especially as distances increase. And this right here is kind of the edge of what you can put into a 223 case, just because, you know, otherwise you're going to be shoving a lot more bullet down into the case, and you're going to start getting beyond the limitations of what the magazine can hold. And of course you have the 77 grain Sierra MatchKings, and really those are kind of the bleeding edge. I don't know of any that start to get into any heavier weights. So with those limitations in mind, what if we wanted to take a 223 Remington cartridge and just get more powder into it? And that's where you start to get into the 22 Nosler. You take the case of that, you take the body, and you blow it out, make it wider. You keep the rim. It's still a 378/1000 rim, so you don't have to change out your bolt head, which is really nice. You don't have to go searching for special parts for your rifle. Everything's kind of standard there, and really all you have to do is just swap out the barrel as well, and then you're good to go. But this one, in addition to just making things bigger, it does make some improvements in some of the other case dimensions. First off, that neck that I said was really short on 223 Remington, and which isn't going to really lend itself to extreme precision, the case that it was kind of based on, the 222 Remington, that has a very long neck. It's going to help keep that bullet really stable as it makes the jump to the lands. The 223 Remington is pretty short, And here on the 22 Nosler, what we've done is we've increased this to 245 thousandths. So it's over the diameter of the bullet, and it's starting to get into some of that good territory where you're going to get a really even jump into the lands. Case length is still limited at 1.670, so it isn't any different than 223. But the shoulder is a vast improvement, taking that 23 degree angle that you get on 223 Remington and turning it into 30 degrees. And with this, you're just going to get a more consistent burn, and you're going to get more burn happening inside the case, as a lot of people say, so that you just get more consistency and you're going to get probably less throat erosion, which is kind of a big deal because the two cases that we're really looking at today, the 224 Valkyrie and this 22 Nosler, since they're both increasing the amount of powder that you're putting behind that, you know, that little tube that you're shoving this bullet down, these are going to increase the rate of your barrel degradation. So that's one thing to keep in mind. 223 isn't necessarily all that great on barrels. It does, you know, kind of burn through them. But compared to these other two, it's a lot nicer. In addition to the case dimensions, you also have the chamber dimensions. 223 Remington is one that's known for having a very short lead before that bullet hits the land, so you can't really seat your bullets out all that far. But they started to make some changes as time went on. You have the 5.56 millimeter chamber, which pushes the lead back just a little bit. And then you get the 223 Wildy or 223 Wild, and that one makes kind of a conical lead going into the lands, and it gets you a little bit longer access for, you know, some of the longer bullets like the 75s, the 77s, and it tends to handle your heavier bullets better. The 22 Nosler kind of expands on that. You get a nice long lead, so you can handle your heavier bullets. This is the kind of cartridge that I think is going to work really well with both your lighter bullets like 55s and be able to flex all the way up to your 75s. And like I was saying, you kind of top out because you are limited by the length of the magazine in an AR-15. You're kind of stuck with your 75 grain bullets. You can't get into anything bigger. There will be people that will chamber this in bolt action rifles, but since this is really designed as an AR platform round, you're probably not going to find any ammunition for that. Everything's going to be kind of limited to that AR style. So yeah, you're going to top out at 77 grains. So what about this mystery round, 224 Valkyrie? There really isn't any hard data out there, but there is a little bit of pirate info out there, and then they have released some imagery, so I think from that we can kind of extrapolate what this case is going to be like and how this thing is going to run. First off, there was a guy out on Shooter's Forum that managed to find one of the cases out at his range, and it was stamped 224 Valkyrie. He said that the base of this thing, the rim, measured out at 419 thousandths, so around 420 thousandths, and that kind of indicates that perhaps this round is based on 6.8 SPC, and what they've done is they've shoved the shoulder back, and then they have necked down to that 224 bullet to hold that. The case length overall, if we extrapolate from there, just kind of based on the imagery that Federal has released, it looks like it's going to be about 1.620 inches in length, somewhere in that ballpark. So it is definitely shorter than 223 and 22 Nosler. And you kind of have to do this because some of the info that Federal has officially released is that they're going to be dealing with a 90 grain SMK bullet, which is just gigantic. And if you're going to be able to run one of those bullets without having to shove it way back into the case, you're going to need a much shorter case in that AR-15 if you want everything to come out to be able to fit in its magazine. So yeah, I think we're looking at about 1.620 inches on case length. The shoulder looks like it's about 30 degrees, much like that 22 Nosler. And the neck length looks like it's also been increased, just looking at the images. And then just kind of extrapolating some of the lengths that I was able to measure on the base, you know, and just looking at the images that they have, it looks like it's going to be about 0.27 inches of length on that neck, which is considerably longer than even you get on that 22 Nosler. So I think this is going to be a really good one for stabilizing those bullets, making sure everything lines up nicely into the lands on the barrel. So I think that this will be a very precise rifle, especially coupled with that 30 degree shoulder. You should get good precise burns, And probably the one thing that I can guess at is that you'll also get a pretty good lead until you actually do hit the lands, just because people are going to be messing with some bigger bullets. I think there's going to be a pretty big jump, and that may make this not an optimal cartridge for some of the lighter bullets. We'll see how this goes, and of course there will be actual hard data later to see how this will go. But it may not handle 55 grain bullets and some of the lighter varmint style stuff quite as well. And that's kind of to be expected since, if the first round that's being developed for this thing uses a 90 grain bullet, if you're cutting things back to about 60% of that mass, then yeah, it's probably not designed for your varmint weight bullets. Now bear in mind that a lot of this discussion is still speculative. SAAMI and Federal have not released true stats on the 224 Valkyrie yet. But I think based on some of the things that we've seen, I think we can still get a pretty decent idea of when to choose one cartridge over the other. And if there is some kind of revelatory information that comes later, I'll make a new video and I'll link to it somewhere here. But I think we still have a pretty good idea of when to pick one over the other. 223 Remington, not going away anytime soon. It's the one that the AR-15 was built around in the first place. So every one of its parts and, you know, all the magazines and stuff, this is one that's going to be economical. There's tons of ammunition out there. And actually the ammunition and all those parts, they're all very effective. The total system is very effective. I use this for shooting prairie dogs. This is a great one for coyote hunting. And you can start to, you know, bump this up into larger game like deer and hogs and that sort of thing, based on what kind of bullet you choose and that sort of thing, you know, how you hand load these maybe. And for me, you know, I have no trouble hitting a prairie dog out to about 350 yards. It does start to get played with by the wind just because those bullets, they aren't moving all that fast and they don't weigh all that much. And so this is where you start to get into the 22 Nosler and where this one is going to be really special. First off, 22 Nosler is going to use a lot of the same parts as 223 Remington, including that bolt. You don't have to swap out the bolt face or anything like that. You don't need special parts. Basically, all you have to do is just swap the magazine over to a 6.8 SPC style magazine, and you need to swap the barrel. And then you're good to go for 22 Nosler. But what you're going to get in return, okay, you're going to get fewer rounds in your magazine, but you are going to get a much flatter trajectory for varmints. And because that case is the exact same length as 223 Remington, you're going to get the benefits and the detractions of bullet selection, basically. You know, if you want to run 55 grain bullets in 22 Nosler, it's going to run great and it's going to go very fast. You're going to get a great flat trajectory there. If you want to get into some of these heavier ones, 75s and 77s, excellent, excellent performance. This would be a great one for deer, for, you know, for folks that don't want a whole lot of recoil or that just want to run an AR-15 platform. And it's going to be a great predator hunter. You're definitely going to be able to increase those distances where you can make hits on things. And it's going to buck the wind a lot better just because it is moving that much faster. 224 Valkyrie, that's where things start to change quite a bit. And I think we're going to kind of get out of varminting for a lot of things, just because there is going to be probably a longer lead in that chamber. And we're going to see over time how this goes. This might not be a cartridge to choose if you want to be shooting your 55 grain bullets. So, you know, we'll see over time how people do with that, if it does indeed handle those lighter bullets really well. But since it is designed for a 90 grain bullet, you know, that's kind of the first loading that we're seeing out there. And that's one of the real telling things about a cartridge is, what is its first bullet? What's it designed for? The 223 Remington was, you know, designed for that 55 grain bullet. And so everything else is just kind of, you know, messing around to see if they can increase performance there, but it's still based on 55. 22 Nosler kind of takes that same formula, so it's still kind of based around 55, but they've done some things to make it handle the bigger stuff a lot better. And then this one, it's designed around a 90 grain bullet. So if you start to deviate from that very much, you're starting to get off kind of in the weeds. But the 90s, they're going to be just excellent for things like the predator hunting that I mentioned earlier. They're going to be great against deer. And I think a lot of the match shooters especially are just going to love this thing. It's going to be very capable in your PRS style of matches, just because there's not going to be that much recoil compared to a lot of others, but it's going to stay supersonic a long time. Those 90 grain bullets are, they're going to make havoc with the wind. The wind is not going to be able to blow them around all that much. So they're just going to keep on trucking, and they're going to deliver a lot more energy downrange than some of these others that are, you know, even a 75 grain pill. You're going to see just a big increase in how much energy you can put on, especially a target like a deer or a hog. Great choice for that. And then, of course, there are going to be the tactical applications. This is one that I can't really comment on because I'm just a hobbyist, but I can really see how if you wanted to be able to take an AR-15 platform and be able to increase the amount of, your hit ratio out at longer ranges and be able to deliver a lot of energy, it makes a ton of sense to me. I think that really all three of those cartridges are, you know, are going to, 223 is going to remain as popular as ever. 22 Nosler, I think, is going to grab, a good chunk of the market, and 224 Valkyrie as well. And for each of them, I really see kind of unique functions for all of them. And I think it just depends on what you want to do. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, be sure to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe. Even if you didn't like this particular content, go ahead and subscribe. There's probably something coming that's more up your alley. Check out this playlist right here. This is going to have videos in a similar vein to what you just watched. These two videos we cherry-picked for you. And finally, The Social Regressive is on Patreon. So, you can become a patron of the Destructive Arts and earn some goodies while helping us to provide high-quality videos just by kicking us a few bucks a month. Thanks a bunch for your patronage.